Hello and welcome, this is Alister Christie, and in this movie we're going to take a quick look at how you can integrate Adobe Flash into your Delphi applications. Let's start by creating a new package. And we want to, in the component menu, go into Import Component, and we want to import an ActiveX control. And the one we're after is ShockwaveFlash. And we'll install it onto the ActiveX palette and just accept all the defaults. And we'll add it to package 1. Now let's save our project. And install it. You have now installed our Flash objects. Let's create a VCL Forms application and on it add a T-Shockwave Flash component. And I'm just going to go to the movie and specify add all flash animation I prepared earlier. And there we have a little flash application running within our Delphi application. And there are a bunch of properties, like I can turn loop off and fiddle with this scale mode. And for example, if I made this much narrower and ran it, it would stretch things out and it's no longer looping. And there are lots of options there, but we'll leave it on the default of 0. And we'll leave loop on as well. Now I have another little example. This is a Camtasia I recorded. And I'm going to make this exactly 320 by 240. And if we run that, we have a short little recording I prepared earlier. And let's save that. Save all. Let's go up to playing and set that false, and we'll add a couple of buttons. And for button 1, call that play, and in that we'll just set playing is assigned. So we can make some play pause button. So if it's playing, it the button one caption should be, if I can spell, pause. And for the other button, I'm just going to call this back to start. And I'm just going to call go to frame, frame number 0. Okay, if we run that, we can now play and pause and play and go back to start. All very exciting. Okay, and let's save all that. Let's now add a progress bar so that we know how far through our movie we've progressed. And in application events, and in the on idle, frame. So this is kind of a lazy way of doing it, but it works. I'll probably get rid of that now. And let's just save that. And if we run that, we can go play, and we've got a little progress bar indicator working down the bottom here. And that was about all I wanted to show you. There's actually a lot more. You can do stuff with buttons and things, but this is good enough for now. Our first step was to create a new package and install the ShockwaveFlash ActiveX control. We could then use that ActiveX control like any other Delphi component. Thanks for taking the time to watch. I hope you've learned something new.